In the vast world of the Marvel Multiverse, there seems to be no shortage of Spider-Man. People with extraordinary spider-based abilities with the freedom to use all that power responsibly, or perhaps choose not to. Hey everybody, I'm Josh Busker.
And I'm Connor Monroe, and today we're going to be teaming up to take a look at the top 10 alternate versions of Spider-Man better than Peter Parker. Don't come for us. In at 10, Spider-Man. In this what-if story, Peter forgets his lunch at home, so Aunt May rushes to the science demonstration to give it to him, cause you know, that's gonna help with the bullying. Except, this causes her to be the one who gets bit by the radioactive spider, and Aunt May becomes Spider-Man. But don't worry, dear, Spider is more of a costume to me than my identity. In truth, I'm just your friendly neighborhood aunt. Using a costume to hide her real identity, May set out to earn money for the family doing stunts. However, when the villain Leapfrog made an appearance, the Spider-Man defeated him and became a crime fighter. And I probably find this too funny, considering how this wasn't like actually invented at the time. However, a Leapfrog is like one of those like Game Boy Light things for kids that, you know, they have like educational games on them or whatnot, or like games where you have to like jump over the logs to get across the river. So I just imagine Aunt May fighting with technology instead of a supervillain, and I love it, it's so good. Not to mention that when the threat of the Inheritors was stopped by transferring their consciousness into infant human babies, the children were adopted by May and brought back to her. I love it.
Coming in at number 9, we've got the malfunctioning spider clone known as Kane. The original very first Peter Parker clone created by the Jackal, Kane was considered a failed experiment due to his cells degenerating into a deformed state. This degeneration also had a side effect of actually enhancing Kane's spider abilities, however, making him initially stronger and faster than the other Spider-Men, and with his spider sense essentially capable of getting brief flashes of future events. Despite his complicated beginnings as a villain of the Clone Saga, particularly taking an interest in fighting Ben Reilly, Kane would go on to find some sort of redemption by taking up the anti-hero mantle of the Scarlet Spider in the city of Houston, finally finding a place where he could carve out his own identity as a hero. From a falling apart bearded version of Peter Parker to a spider that can stand on its own, that's one hell of a character arc for a clone named Kane.
And at 8, Miguel O'Hara. Miguel was born after his mother had an affair with her husband's boss, Tyler Stone, the vice president of Alchemax. Yeah, that's not gonna create any issues. After being forced to start human trials on research that wasn't complete, Miguel went to Stone to quit from his position at Alchemax. However, Stone ended up giving him a dose of a highly addictive substance known as Rapture. Alchemax was the only place that made Rapture, so he figured that since he was now addicted, Miguel would have to stay. But Miguel had programmed his own DNA into the machine it used in the human trial as kind of like a control, so he was able to put himself in the machine and tried to reset his DNA back to what it was before he was addicted to Rapture, because Rapture combines with your DNA. But this instead combined his DNA with that of a spider, which granted him the same powers as Spider-Man, but on a non-radioactive level, along with a couple upgrades like telepathy and talons that grow from his fingertips. It was actually so bad it caused some dude to fall to his death, so I actually kind of want some.
Coming in at number 7 is a character that started out as a pun, but wound up becoming so much more. It's the Spectacular Spider-Ham. Going under the name of Peter Porker, and a bit confused as to whether he's a pig with the strength and agility of a spider, or a spider with all the limitations of a pig, Spider-Ham comes from a version of the Marvel Universe where everyone is some form of anthropomorphic animal. Although initially only appearing in parody storylines against villains such as Dr. Doom and Raven the Hunter, Peter Porker would prove he could more than hold his own when he crossed over into the mainstream Marvel Universe to help save the world from the vampiric, soul-sucking Inheritors. That'll do, pig. That'll do.
In at 6, Otto Octavius. After brain swapping with Peter, leaving Peter's consciousness in his own dying body, Otto Octavius decided to become a better Spider-Man, a superior one, if you will. During his time as Spider-Man, Otto shattered Scorpion's jaw, blinded the Vulture, and killed the Mass Murderer Massacre. Man, that's a lot of M's. He also performed numerous involuntary acts, like stopping himself from killing Boomerang, which was later revealed to be because a small bit of Peter was still alive inside of Otto. When the Avengers decided to examine Spider-Man to find a reason for this change of behavior, they couldn't find anything. But after thinking that he expelled Peter, Octavius helped Mayor Jameson assist with the execution of Alistair Smythe. And even though Smythe managed to temporarily take over the Raft, Otto managed to defeat his allies, Vulture, Boomerang, and Scorpion, and kill the villain, secretly taking the Vulture as a captive, because, you know, that's what Otto does. During the conflict, though, Jameson ordered Spider-Man to execute Smythe when he had escaped, and then using this evidence to blackmail Jameson, Spider-Man forced the mayor to allow the Raft to become his new headquarters that he called Spider Island 2, which, I mean, like, it's pretty badass, but, like, it's a little shifty, or a lot shifty, but I like your chutzpah, okay? We need these kind of cutthroat tactics in the superhero world, okay? Good on you, Otto.
Coming in at number 5, we've got John Jameson, the Astro Spider. That's right, in the alternate universe of Earth 3145, the son of infamous Spidey hater J. Jonah Jameson is actually himself a space-themed version of Spider-Man. During a trip during his day job as an astronaut, John Jameson found himself with a spider inside his spacesuit while being bombarded with cosmic rays. Don't you hate when that happens? These rays merge their genetics and turn John Jameson into the Astro Spider. Instead of web fluid, John's webs are made of psychic energy, and on top of all of his usual spider abilities, he has the telepathic ability to read minds. Something tells me that his father might not approve of his new line of work, however.
In it for Ben Reilly. Ben Reilly is a clone of Peter Parker, but goes on to create his own identity of Scarlet Spider. So technically, it isn't Peter, okay? Ben was created by Miles Warren, the supervillain known as the Jackal, to torment actual Spider-Man. Seemingly, he died in their first encounter. But the clone actually ended up surviving and exiled himself for 5 years, only returning to New York after learning that Aunt May was sick. Because I guess technically he's her aunt, or she's his aunt too. Semantics. After making amends with Peter, Ben fought alongside him as the Scarlet Spider. For a brief period of time, Ben and Peter were actually tricked by Norman Osborn to believe that Ben was the real Peter Parker. So the guy currently going by the name Peter left New York with his wife, Mary Jane. You know. And then left Ben to pick up the mantle of Spider-Man, because, you know, why not? Might as well. During the events of another fight against Osborn, though, as the Green Goblin, Ben was impaled and died in Peter's arms, also discovering that Peter being the clone was just total BS. It was a lie. So, I mean, like, at least the real Peter didn't die. He would later be revived, but still, this is one of the most iconic Spider-Man alternate versions in existence, so you knew he was gonna be on this list.
At number 3, we've got Gwen Stacy, aka Spider-Gwen, aka Spider-Woman, aka Ghost Spider. Jeez, this girl goes by a lot of names. In an alternate universe where Gwen Stacy and not Peter Parker was the one bitten by a radioactive spider, things turned out much differently than the regular Marvel universe. Bullied relentlessly by his peers and without any powers of his own, this version of Peter eventually becomes the Lizard after stealing Dr. Connor's serum and has to be tragically killed by his best friend Gwen before he can hurt anyone else. This leaves Spider-Gwen feeling she must atone for her friend's death and become the greatest hero she can, something she's continued to do over the years with more and more crossovers into the mainstream Marvel Universe, where she can help and perhaps even outpace the Peter Parker of their world.
Penultimately, in at number 2, Stan Lee. One of the major elements of Spider-Geddon is that the book is packed with spider beings or spiderlings from every corner of the Marvel Universe. Ignore the fact that I messed up saying corner. We're talking Spider UK, Octavia Otto, Spider Woman, which is Aunt May from Earth 982, which is different from Spider-Man, don't worry, Spider-Gwen, Spider-Ham, and many, many more. This crossover even gave us a real alternate universe version of Spider-Cop, which, as a fan of the PlayStation game, I have to admit, makes me feel warm and fuzzy inside. And it also made the Spider-Man from that game, who was also in this crossover, very happy. However, in addition to the tribute artwork at the top of the comic, did Marvel sneak another version of Stan Lee in for the fans with a keen eye? It seems so. On page 25 of Spider-Geddon number 5, the final issue in this run, we can see two instances of a Spider-Man who looks very familiar, and not in the he's a Spider-Man kind of way. This character is present in both panels 1 and 3 of this page, and looks nearly identical to Stan Lee, especially with like his whole signature look thing. So, by far, my favorite version of the character. Rest in peace, Stan Lee.
Coming in at our number 1 spot, we've got to go with Miles Morales, the name that is quickly becoming just as associated with Spider-Man as the iconic Peter Parker. Originally appearing in the Ultimate Marvel Universe following the death of their own version of Spider-Man, Miles Morales was a young boy from Brooklyn with an origin story strikingly similar to Peter Parker's, but with some twists. Bitten by a radioactive spider from Osborn Industries, Miles' reason for getting his powers was due to his supervillain uncle, Aaron Davis, otherwise known as the Prowler. Quickly becoming an exciting new take on Spider-Man in his own universe, Miles Morales proved to be such a hit that he was eventually combined into the regular Marvel Universe, and formed a friendship slash mentorship with its still alive version of Peter Parker. While many have become spider themed heroes over the years, Miles Morales is a character that best shows the youth and heroism that so many of us love about Spider-Man, and goes to show that anyone is capable of wearing the mask. Miles never gives up and never stops trying, and for that, he might just be the very best Spider-Man.
There we have it, friends, the top 10 alternate versions of Spider-Man better than Peter Parker.
Which version of Spider-Man is your favorite, and who would you have put on this list? Be sure you let us know down in the comments.
Thank you all so much for watching.
I've been Josh Busker.
And I have been and shall remain Connor Monroe, and we'll see you in another video.